الله. بلى. ما جسسته إرس يوم عرفة.
A great day in the Islamic calendar. A great day in the Islamic world. A great day for a Muslim. Whoever understands his deen, he knows the day of Arafah is not a day to be played with or to waste, because it's an opportunity of a lifetime. You don't know if you will live to see the next Arafah. It is the day that Allah said, I completed your deen for you, and I completed my favors upon you, and I am pleased, and I have chosen for you Islam as a way of life. It was on day of, on Arafah. It was on the day of Arafah that this great ayah revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is a day that Allah will be boasting to the angels, telling them, just look. Because brothers and sisters in faith, it is a day that you will see millions of people gathered under one ground. Men and women, the rich and the poor, the old and the young, the strong and the weak, all gathered under one ground, affirming the oneness of Allah. All you hear is لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Please do yourself a favor. Tomorrow, give a sadaqah. Do yourself a big favor. Tomorrow, make a poor person, a needy, smile. Please make it a day tomorrow. Tomorrow, make sure you make a needy, someone who is in need, make him smile. Put some happiness in his heart and see what Allah will do for you. Please try. And remember, whatever you give tomorrow, it's not like what you will give the rest of the days, including Ramadan.
Alhamdulillahi alladhi lam yattakhidh waladan wa lam yakun lahu sharikun fil mulki wa ma kana ma'ahu min ilah. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في أرضه وسمائه، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله، القائل أنا سيد ولد آدم ولا فخرا. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه الأتقياه البررة وعلى من هدهم وسلك سبيلهم إلى يوم الدين وبعد. My brother and my dear sister, Allah is الوكيل. Allah is الوكيل, the disposer of affairs. Allah is الوكيل, the supreme trustee. Allah is الوكيل, the one who is in charge of everything. Allah is الوكيل, the maintainer of everything. So brother, all your affairs, give it to الوكيل. ذلكم الله ربكم ذلكم الله ربكم. Such is Allah, your Lord. خالق كل شيء فاعبدوه. The creator of everything. So worship him alone. So serve him alone. Why?
وهو على كل شيء وكيل.
He is the disposer of everything, all affairs. He is the maintainer of everything. He is in charge. So give it to him, worship him alone, and trust him, and put your trust in him. Brothers and sisters in faith, in everything, say, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel. Allah is enough for you. I bear witness. He alone deserves to be worshipped. And I bear witness.
our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is Allah's last and final messenger.
وقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا ويقول الذين كفروا لست مرسلا.
And the disbelievers said, and the non-believers said, يا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم, you are not a messenger.
قل كفى بالله شهيدا بيني وبينكم.
Tell them, Allah is enough as a witness between you and I. What is the witness?
Yasin wal Quran al Hakim innaka la minal mursalin.
Allah said, I swear by my noble book Al Quran that ya Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you are one of my messengers. Brothers and sisters in faith, he is the last and the final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whoever wants to go to Allah, whoever wants to be pleased, want Allah to be pleased with him, whoever wants Allah to accept him, must go and pass through the door of Sayyiduna Rasulullah.
قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم.
Tell them, if truly you love Allah, then tell them I said for them to obey you. I say for them to obey you. If truly they love me, who is speaking? Allah. If you love Allah, then follow Sayyidina Rasulullah. Then Allah will love you and Allah will forgive you your sin, because he is the only way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he will be the first to knock at the door of Jannah. Brothers and sisters in faith, he said, Ati bab al jannati yawm al qiyamah فأستفتح فيقول الخازن من. I will come to the gate, to the door, to the gate of heaven, the day of judgment. فأستفتح, and I will knock, I will seek its opening. فيقول الخازن, and the keeper of the door will say, من, who is at the door? فأقول محمد, and I will say, it's Muhammad. And he will say, بك أمرت لا أفتح لأحد قبلك. I have been given permission not to open it to anyone and for anyone before you, ya Rasulullah. Brothers and sisters in faith, and if you want to be behind him on that day, obey him, follow his footsteps, because if you obey Allah, if you obey him, you have indeed obeyed Allah.
من يطع الرسول فقد أطاع الله.
سيدنا رسول الله, اللهم صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه. بس الحمد لله.
We are still in the best days of the year. We are still in the best days of the world. As the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيها أحب إلى الله من هذه الأيام. There are no days in which good deed is beloved, is more pleased to Allah than these days.
The first 10 days of the Hijjah.
قالوا ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله يا رسول الله. Even to strive in the cause of Allah.
قال ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله.
Even to strive in the cause of Allah. إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. Except a man who goes out with everything. He goes out with his wealth and he did not return.
He did not return with anything, himself and his wealth.
Everything is gone.
Otherwise,
there are no deeds more beloved to Allah
than deeds in this first 10 days of the Hijjah.
So alhamdulillah, we are still in the best days of the
world. But subhanallah, is gone.
Most of it is gone. Most is gone, but the most significant one is coming, is yet to come.
Most of it is gone, but the most virtuous and the most significant one is yet to come. Brothers and sisters in faith, do you know what I'm talking about? We all know as Muslims that the most sacred nights in the life of a Muslim is Laylatul Qadr.
Laylatul Qadr khayrun min alf shahr.
We all know that, right? That's the most sacred nights in the life of a Muslim is the night of power, Laylatul Qadr.
And brothers and sisters, do you know that the most significant day, the most sacred day, Aqdas, the most sacred day in the life of a Muslim is the day of Arafah. Allahumma lakal hamd.
It is the day of Arafah.
Brother and my dear sister,
Allah swore by this day
by saying, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ.
عن أبي هريرة رضي الله عنه قال قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم يوم الموعود
is يوم القيامة.
Because Allah said, وَالسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الْبُرُوجِ, I swear by the sky full of constellation. وَالْيَوْمِ الْمَوْعُودِ, and I swear by the day, I swear by the promised day. وَشَاهِدٍ وَمَشْهُودٍ, Allah said, I swear by the witness and the witnessed.
قال رسول الله, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said,
يوم الموعود in that ayah is يوم القيامة. يوم الموعود is يوم القيامة. And يوم المشهود يوم عرفة. And a shahid, that is in the ayah, يوم الجمعة. So Allah swore by this great day that is approaching, that is coming to you and I, inshallah, tomorrow. So Allahumma lakal hamd. Brothers and sisters of faith, it is a day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed our deen for us. It is the day that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala completed His favors upon us.
اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا.
It is the day that Allah said, I completed your deen for you, and I completed my favors upon you, and I am pleased, and I have chosen for you Islam as a way of life. It was on day of on Arafah. It was on the day of Arafah that this great ayah revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It is a day that Allah will be boasting to the angels, telling them, just look. Because brothers and sisters in faith, it is a day that you will see millions of people gathered under one ground, men and women, the rich and the poor, the old and the young, the strong and the weak, all gathered under one ground, affirming the oneness of Allah. All you hear is labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, innal hamda wan ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. People gathered together wearing the same color cloth, affirming the oneness of Allah, glorifying Allah, praising Allah.
Yes, because yes and yes and yes, and absolutely He deserves to be glorified and to be praised, Allah.
And Allah will be boasting to the angels,
I told you, look at them. What do they want? Ya Allah.
What are they looking for? What do they want from me?
At the end, Allah says to the angels, I want you to witness, I've forgiven all of them. Not them alone.
Not only them,
but inshallah,
you and I are here.
We will be included, inshallah.
By taking some actions, by moving, by doing some of the things that Allah loves.
Because the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِنْ أَيَّامٍ الْعَمَلُ الصَّالِحُ فِيهَا أَحَبُّ إِلَى اللَّهِ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأَيَّامِ.
There are no days in which good deed is more beloved, is more pleased to Allah than these days. So if you want to be with them as they are standing on Mount Arafah, glorifying Allah, praising Allah, crying to Allah, asking His forgiveness, brother, you can achieve same while you are here in your house, while you are here in your house, while you are in the house of Allah, while you are at your job. It is achievable because Allah is Al-Kareem, the most generous. Allah is Al-Kareem. Allah knows you want to go, but you're not able for a reason. So Allah is Al-Kareem.
If you do good deeds, you will meet them in reward, inshallah.
Brother and my dear sister, it is Yawm Arafah. A great day in the Islamic calendar, a great day in the Islamic world, a great day for a Muslim. Whoever understands his deen, he knows the day of Arafah is not a day to be played with or to waste, because it's an opportunity of a lifetime. You don't know if you will live to see the next Arafah. Inshallah. In few hours, we will meet the day of Arafah. So, brother and my dear sister, number one, take this from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم صيام يوم عرفة أحتسب على الله أن يكفر السنة التي قبله والتي بعدها. First, what you should prepare yourself for, to fast tomorrow. Do not waste it. Do not. Fast tomorrow. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fasting on the day of Arafah, I hope that it expiates the year, the sin of the year before it and the year after it. 2 years sin of your life will be wiped out, will be removed, will be erased by fasting tomorrow. So get ready. You and your wife, get ready. You and your children, make sure you fast tomorrow. This is number one. And remember, fasting tomorrow is not like fasting in the rest of the what? Of the days, including Ramadan. I repeat, fasting tomorrow is greater than fasting in the rest of the days, including Ramadan. So fast tomorrow, get ready and work hard. Cry to Allah, purify your soul, because قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ زَكَّهَا. Indeed, purified, successful is he who purified his soul. So let's fast tomorrow. It is the day of Arafah and it's coming tomorrow. Number two, brother, can I give you a secret? It's a secret, and I'm telling only those I love. Please do yourself a favor tomorrow, give a sadaqah. Do yourself a big favor tomorrow, make a poor person, a needy, smile. Please make it a day tomorrow. Tomorrow, make sure you make a needy, someone who is in need, make him smile. Put some happiness in his heart and see what Allah will do for you. Please try it.
And remember, whatever you give tomorrow, it's not like what you will give the rest of the days, including Ramadan. So as I'm talking now, I want you to start thinking, I know that woman, I know that man, I know that sick person, I know those orphans. Do it tomorrow, it is a secret. I'm telling you, Allah will surprise you. Make them happy. It is the day of Arafah, the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah and the day of Arafah. Give sadaqah. And whenever you give them, just look at them and say, I don't need any thanks from you. All I'm looking for is Allah to be pleased with me. I gave it to Allah and see what Allah will do for you. No matter how small it is, to you it's small, but to the needy and the poor, they need it. So tomorrow, make it a day. Tomorrow I am going to give sadaqah. I am going to give something big. I am going to make someone smile. And Allah will make you smile the rest of your life. Allahumma ameen. The next thing to do. The third thing to do, inshallah, tomorrow, my dear brother and my dear sister, make dua. Bring all your problems to Allah. I repeat, bring all your problems. Whatever you need, say it tomorrow. Tell Allah what you want now and what you want in future. Allah is waiting to listen to you. Do you know why? It is a great day. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. Hold that peace. He said the best dua is the dua of the day of Arafah. خير الدعاء دعاء يوم عرفة. The best dua is the dua of the day of Arafah. So bring all the problems, no matter how big they are, bring it to Al-Qadir, the able. Say everything, do not leave anything, because you are talking to who? Al-Qadir, the able, the capable. He can change it, the situation. Listen, that sadness, he can change it into happiness. Bring it to Allah. Bring all your problems to Allah. He will solve it for you. Believe in Him. Trust Him. He is Al-Wakilu. He is Al-Qadiru. He can change things around. He can turn them around. He can bring them, make them better. Allah. So bring all your problems to Allah. Allahu alladhi yursilu ar-riyah فتثير سحابا فيبسطه في السماء كيف يشاء ويجعله كسفا فترى الودق يخرج من خلاله فإذا أصاب به من يشاء من عباده إذا هم يستبشرون وإن كانوا من قبل أن ينزل عليهم من قبله لمبلسون. Allah can change things around, and whenever it comes, after you have despair, after you have lost hope, you know it's not going to happen. Allah said, I can change it. I can bring it back. I can make it happen. As He said, the end of the ayah, فَانْظُرْ إِلَىٰ آثَارِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ كَيْفَ يُحْيِي الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا إِنَّ ذَلِكَ لَمُحْيِي الْمَوْتَى. فَانْظُرْ Just look. إِلَىٰ آثَارِ رَحْمَةِ اللَّهِ Look at the prince of Allah's mercy. فانظر إلى آثار رحمة الله كيف يحيي الأرض بعد موتها. How he revived the earth after its death.
إن ذلك لمحيي الموتى وهو على كل شيء قدير.
He is capable.
That sadness can be happiness, inshallah. So make dua. Tomorrow, Arafah, can I advise you again? If you can take off from work, take off.
It's an advice, a lovely advice.
Just stay and worship Allah. After Fajr prayer, do not leave until the sunrise. Stay. Make dhikr after Fajr. Until the sunrise, then you get up and make nafila.
Do you know you will get the reward of Hajj and Umrah complete, as said by Rasulullah?
Do it tomorrow. Make sure tomorrow your local masjid is full. Pray Fajr prayer in Jama'ah, because your Fajr prayer in Jama'ah tomorrow is not like the Fajr prayer in the rest of the days, including Ramadan. After you finish, do not leave. Stay in the masjid. Make dhikr. Sunrise, get up. Pray only two nafila.
Allah will give you the reward of Hajj and Umrah.
While they are there, you are here, Allah will give you rewards of Hajj and Umrah.
Complete. This is the saying of Sayyiduna Rasulullah. أقول قولي هذا.
الحمد لله.
وصلاة وسلام على سيدنا رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. Brother, Friday, first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. And you know, after Asr, there's a special time that Allah accepts dua, right? Yes. As the Prophet ﷺ said, Friday, first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah.
إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما.
Make sure you send many salutations, many salawats to sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
And when you do that, you are doing yourself a favor,
because Allah will bless you. It is the first 10 days of Dhul Hijjah.
Yo, Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammadin. Today is not like the rest of the days, because you are in the best days of dunya, of the world. So brother and my dear sister, do yourself a favor. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Do it as much as you can and earn the blessings, and earn the mercy, and earn the tranquility, and earn the favors of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because whoever sends salutation upon him, whoever invokes blessing upon him, Allah will bless him. I pray, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you. May Allah bless us all. May Allah make things easy for us. May Allah forgive us our sins. Ya Allah, we thank you. You give us long life, health, that we witness these beautiful days. Ya Allah, we pray that we see tomorrow. Yes, not all will see tomorrow. Some will not live to see it. Is it me or you? Nobody knows. So make dua. May Allah make it easy for you and I to witness tomorrow, to ask Allah for help, to serve Allah as He wants to be served. May Allah forgive our mothers and fathers. Ya Allah, our brothers and sisters in Palestine. Ya Allah. Ya Allah, you listen to our dua. We thank you for everything. Ya Allah, help our brothers and sisters in Gaza. Ya Allah, help our brothers and sisters in Gaza, Ya Allah. Allahumma ansur ikhwanana al-mustada'afina fi Gaza. Allahumma ansurhum ala a'da'ihim, Ya Allah. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma dammir a'da' al-Din. Wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billahi al-'aliyyil 'azhim. Allahumma arzuqna al-wuqufa bi 'Arafah, Ya Rabb. يا أرحم الراحمين. وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عبدك ونبيك محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. وقم إلى صلاتكم ارحمكم.